This time on Come Dine With Me.
Hey!
It's party time!
Boosting.
I am the hostess with the mostest.
They're the best peppers that we've had this week.
Buffoonery.
You've got a really big hatch, haven't you?
You know what they say, don't you? A big hatch makes a good catch.
And a battle for supremacy.
Who's the most competitive between all us?
I think Jen.
I don't enter a competition just for the fun of it. I enter it to try and win it.
As four hosts fight for a grand.
Babies come out from there with two legs, not four.
This week we're in Burnley, where in the surrounding hills the infamous Pendle Witch Trials took place. That's a poor effort. Also living in the hills above and pretty scary herself is our first host, hairdresser Jane Dickinson.
If a person shh me, I go louder. And I turn round and say, don't shh me, you shush. Shh.
Shush.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I rate my cooking 9.7, because I'm well good at it. I am extremely competitive. There's no point entering a competition if you don't enter it to win it, is there?
I am going to win this competition, and I am going to blow the other competitors out of the water.
Whoa! Swords at the ready! Meet second contestant Mark Dempsey, a bar and catering manager at the local theatre.
If people are serving things incorrectly or there can be improvements, I would point out and sort of drop into conversation, have you thought of, you could do it this way.
Have you thought of dancing lessons?
If I was invited to a dinner party where it was sophisticated and fine dining, I'm hoping I could adapt to that, but I'd definitely be out of my comfort zone. I'm more of a tea on lap type guy.
Say hey up to our third competitor, wedding DJ Kev Riley.
Come on, everybody, who's having a good time tonight?
I've gone for a lot of effort to enter this competition. I've learned how to switch my oven on.
Great!
I've learned how to clean it. I've learned how to prepare food.
OK.
I've learned how to... I've learned that I need a chopping board.
You might need to up your game, Kev. Oh, nice hairnet.
If someone does criticise my food tonight, it'll not be good, because there's no need to criticise it, because it'll be mega.
Well, you heard it here first, as Burnley's answer to Nora Batty prepares her mega starter, a trio of Dunsop Bridge trout.
This trout, this morning, was swimming out there in the river. So when I cooked it, it was 25 minutes dead.
Sounds good. How'd you kill it? Wash, set and blow dry? To make the first two in the trio, a mousse and a pâté, Jane debones one of her fresh fish.
Da-da-da-da. Bones doesn't give you prizes. If there's a bone, they'll downmark me.
She then takes half the trout, adds lemon zest, cream and mayo before mixing in gelatin to set into a mousse.
My guests today are going to look at the starter and think, well, that sounds great.
I have a feeling this trio of trout, one of the trio will be a smoked fish. I'm just hoping that another one isn't a creamy in a creamy sauce.
Your luck's out, Mark. Jane prepares the fishy pâté by combining cream cheese, horseradish, lemon and chives.
Mmm, it's a great trout pâté.
Great!
Next course.
These are Boland lamb shanks. How good do they look?
For main, Jane's serving braised Boland lamb shanks with mash and beetroot.
I don't eat lamb because of the little lambs running in the field, and it's the principle of the thing. It makes my tummy turn.
Completing our lineup is fluffy lamb-loving BID TV presenter Sally Jacks. Recognise her?
I've been dancing since I was three, singing since I was six, acting since I was seven, and then I got told I talked too much and I got a job in radio, and then Cheryl Baker got me the job at BID TV.
Speaking of talking too much...
Ooh, it's a bit spitty.
Jane fries onion with fennel before cumin and tomato paste are added.
Mmm, it smells good. If they don't like it tonight, there's nothing else. They can just eat the mash and the beetroot.
In goes stock, a can of tomatoes and beans before warming through.
Mmm, job's a good one.
Pat yourself on the back there, Nora. How good's your dessert going to be? Lemon posset with shortbread.
Well, I thought I said possum for a minute. I'm guessing that's just lemon and shortbread.
To make the possums, sorry, possets, Jane whips cream, sugar and lemon juice.
This is really good, this.
She then rolls out pastry and cuts into funny little shapes.
Look at that. They're lovely, aren't they? Ooh, yummy.
Ooh, yummy.
A luscious lemon posset.
Yikes. The mixture is poured into martini glasses and chilled.
It sounds gorgeous. They sound posh.
Not really.
I'm probably not going to like this person because from the look of this menu, they are going to be good competition for me.
Something different about you, Jane?
Ta-da!
Thought so. First to arrive is competitive Mark.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Welcome. Mwah. How are you?
Very well,
Come
thank you, Mark.
Straight into the lounge, Mark.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Hope those hinges are strong.
Cheers.
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 To a good week.
The first
yes.
of many.
Yes.
Next in is Burnley lad, Kev.
Tony's at the door.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome. Hiya. Come on in. I'm Kev. James. Kev. How are you?
Nice to
Pleased
meet you.
Pleased to meet you, Kev.
Got you that.
Oh, thank you very much. How are you? If you'd like to make your way into the lounge.
Thank you.
Hinges are still holding.
Hi, you okay, Mark? Hiya.
Kev, how are you doing?
Very right? well, yeah, you?
Yeah, good to
good,
meet
good.
You.
Good, good.
Would you like me to get you a glass of champagne?
Please, yeah.
No Thanks problem.
No. See you well?
Yeah, good, are you?
Yeah, not bad. Not bad. Did it take you long to get here?
Quite a while, yeah.
Try talking about the weather.
It's very cold outside.
I know, freezing.
Freezing.
Yes, thankfully, TV's Sally Jax is a pro at small talk.
Hello!
I'm Jane, come on in.
Pleased to meet you. Pleased to meet you, Jane, here you are.
Oh, thank you.
There we go. And I didn't know whether you were a man or a woman. I don't
Have a wild guess.
Because obviously we don't know.
I think I'm all
yeah,
woman.
You are all woman.
Come on in and welcome to my home.
Oh,
how are you?
Yeah, yeah, really good, really good.
It's all right, Dor, you're safe now.
Nice to
Hello,
meet you.
Hello, how
Kev.
Are you?
How are
all right,
you?
Kev, how are you?
Mark, pleased to meet you.
Hello,
you well,
you?
Darling.
Yes, very well,
Good.
Thank you, very
would
well.
Would you like me to get you a glass of champagne?
I would
And
love...
would you like me to take your
yes,
jacket?
Yes, thank you very much.
Oh, my gosh. Sally's quite loud.
Pot, kettle.
I think I'll deal with it.
Coming up, pulling out the stops.
I went through the trout farm and I got 6 in the net.
Oh my gosh, you're amazing.
Pouring out the sauce.
We should all guess what you are.
Pig 3 model.
I think some people could find it offensive.
And pushing for victory.
It's Battle of the Lamb.
The claws might be out tonight.
It's night one in Burnley and hairdresser Jane Dickinson is aiming to wow 3 guests.
I am the hostess with the mostess.
Oh, and she's just itching to show off how good she is.
Oh! It's like being in a Michelin star restaurant.
I can just tell that Jane's pulled out all the stops and made a terrific effort.
And to really wow them, Jane's made not one, but 3 starters. A trio of trout.
Ta-da! Enjoy.
Looks fantastic.
So, Jane, I read on this, it says the Dunsop Bridge trout, so it's obviously...
Yeah, just across the field there.
The river?
Yeah.
So you've caught these?
Yeah, this morning.
You've caught this morning?
I went through the trout farm and I got 6 in the net.
Oh my gosh, you're amazing.
Wow, so who gutted it for you?
Me, I got.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Can we find something that Jane doesn't do?
Modesty?
Actually, I don't call putting a net into a river or into a lake and scooping out 3 trout actually catching fish.
Well, what would you call it then?
I have to say I'm not a fish lover.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I will try,
try it
all.
I would try the mousse first, because
okay.
I think you'd like the mousse. Yeah.
Right.
It's just not as fishy.
The mousse is in the sort of slimy, gooey sort of side of fish. At one point, it made me a bit retchy.
Have you finished your meal?
Thank you.
Oh, good. Put your knife and fork together, Mark. 4:20.
You're not going to waste that, are you?
Oh, Mark.
I'll finish that. Fussy boy. He didn't finish his, so I thought... Get that in.
Oh my gosh.
Really?
How awful is he? Down the hatch.
Would you like mine as well, Kev?
Next to me. Didn't finish it. Get that in as well.
Oh my gosh, he's
going
to
Oh, it's going.
Ooh. There we go.
Might as well get my money's worth.
Oh, Kev, you've got a really big hatch, haven't you?
You know what they say, don't you? A big hatch makes a good catch.
So far, I think that I get on with everybody. It's early days, but I seem to have struck a rapport quite quickly with them all.
You sound a bit annoyed by that, Kev. In the kitchen, Jane's preparing the side dishes for her main.
This is honey. And you put the honey in with the beetroot, so it stops it tasting too rooty.
Time to check on the lamb.
Ta-da! Oh, it's a slippy little sucker.
Oh, it's not still alive, is it? She plates up her lamb shanks with a side of vegetables. And it's ready to go.
This is for you, the big boy in the corner, cos I thought you've a good appetite.
You've heard my reputation.
No, she watched you hoovering up everyone's leftovers.
You've pulled it off again.
Mmm, gorgeous.
Is it nice?
Absolutely.
The meal was fantastically cooked, brilliantly presented. I've got some tough competition on my hand, which I'm sure I can deal with.
I don't usually eat lamb.
Oh, my gosh.
No, it's fine, Jane. Don't worry about it. I'm going to try this.
Do what you can.
Yes. I felt really, truly awful in front of Jane, cos I don't want her to think that, you know, oh, I don't like her food. It's nothing to do with it. It's just a thing that I've always had.
You think about them running around in fields.
Please.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not helping.
I will always try. I will always try. But, no, it's not for me and it hasn't changed my mind.
I'll tell you what is delicious, though, Sally, is the mash.
I'm just going to go and...
I know. Have a go with the mash.
Just imagine it's a mashed lamb.
Oh, Kevin, that's terrible.
Honestly, Kev.
Quick, someone change the subject.
Well, Sally, I think that we should all guess what you are. I think you're in marketing, some sort of marketing. I'm not sure what.
Where do you get marketing from?
You look a bit markety.
Markety?
What do you think she is, Kev?
Page 3 model?
Oh, he didn't just say that.
You asked me to guess.
What on earth gives you that thought?
Blonde, attractive.
Oh, that's very... Oh, that's very nice.
I got myself out of that one.
Yeah, you did. Kev, I think some people could maybe find him offensive with some of the things that he's saying, but he totally doesn't mean it.
I'm not so sure.
I think Sally would have been quite happy that I guessed that she was a page 3 model. If I was a woman, I'd find that complimentary.
She's a very attractive lady. But I don't know about page 3 model. She's not got the height.
The height? Oh, go on, Sally, I know you're dying to tell them.
I'm on the box in your front room.
What, you mean you're a TV presenter?
Yeah, I work in TV, yeah.
Oh, QVC.
Not quite that good.
You're really...
Bid Up TV.
Yeah.
No That's way!
Way!
What my other half watches, Bid Up TV.
Bid.
No way!
Bid TV.
I was nearly there.
You mean really?
That's what he switches back to when you come in the room.
Kevin. It's really funny. Oh, dear.
Hopefully Jane's dessert will tickle them too.
There we go. Three little raspberries on top. They all get a little biscuit each.
Oh, careful, don't spoil them.
And then they all get a little love heart.
And there it is, lemon posset with homemade shortbread.
What's that then? Is it like a mousse?
It's not strawberries. They're raspberries.
I've never had one, I don't think.
Raspberries are my favourite.
Yeah, gorgeous.
What about Kev saying that a raspberry were a strawberry? I said, it's not a strawberry, Kev, it's a raspberry. He's never lived, has he?
No, that's good, actually.
It is delicious, though, isn't it?
Yes, that's enough of that. Taxi!
I thought the lemon posset was fantastic. I think I liked it even as much as what Jane did.
I would give myself, out of 10, 9.9, cos I think we've had a great night.
She might have pulled off a hat-trick if I didn't get a trout starter.
Tonight, I'm going to give Jane an 8.
I'm going to give Jane a 7.
I'm going to give Jane an 8.
So, Jane scores an impressive 23, so maybe she was right to brag a little bit. It's day 2 in Burnley, and today's host, Mark, wants to raise the bar.
I am the most competitive person in this group. I'm in it to win it, and tonight's dinner party is going to be superb.
What? Better than Jane's?
I think it's going to be hard for people to match what I did last night.
Well, Mark's having a crack at it. He's going head-to-head with another lamb dish.
My main is the best-tasting lamb dish ever.
We've been here before. For his main, he'll be serving a shoulder of lamb confit with mango salsa and red currant reduction.
I don't know what that is, but I like mango, chilli and salsa. Red currant will be something new for me again.
Having lamb again? Sick of lamb.
Oh, wow, look at that. Absolutely perfect. Now it's time to get messy. Last night at Jane's dinner party, she really complimented her own food. Slightly over the top, but I tell you what, this lamb is perfect.
Oh, hello. Mark adds red currant jelly and mint sauce to his shredded confit of lamb and rolls into a sausagey thing. If you fancy playing with your sausage, go to the Channel 4 website and save today's recipes into your own online scrapbook. So, who's your friend?
This is Marvin, and Marvin goes everywhere with me, sleeps with me in bed, bathes with me in the bath. You are my little baby.
But he can't cook your starter for you. Pan-seared venison with parsnip chips.
That sounds fantastic. I've never tried venison.
I wouldn't choose to have that off a menu, because obviously it is deer, so it is like the lamb running around the field.
This is going to be the best starter of the week.
I don't like venison.
Blimey, someone's hard to please today.
Want to try some, Marvin?
No thanks, Mark. Ruff. Venison trimmed, he'll fry it later tonight. So straight on with dessert. White chocolate cheesecake with raspberry vodka coulis.
That is the winner for me.
That sounds like my cup of tea. I'd be really interested to try that.
Get in! Two fans in the bag already.
Cheesecake could be a bit sickly.
What's wrong with you today?
The most critical out of this group is definitely going to be Jane.
I think I'm still in the lead with my menu.
I think the cow disagrees.
You knew that was coming, didn't you? It licked right on me bum! Me bum cheek!
Moving on, Mark's getting inventive.
Just realised I don't actually own a rolling pin this very second, so I'm going to use the bottom of a wine bottle. Thinking on my toes.
Or feet. He adds melted butter to his biscuits, then flattens into a cake tin with a potato masher. Thinking on your toes again.
Lovely even base.
He mixes cream cheese, double cream and icing sugar with the melted white chocolate.
It is quite a tiring pudding on the old arm.
And adds this topping to his biscuit base.
Perfect.
With three courses ready to go, Mark...
Marvin, come on, Babby.
..and Babby Marvin are ready to welcome their first guest, ultra-competitive Jane. Brought your own pudding?
Hello.
Hello.
Come
How
in, darling.
Are ya?
Does Marvin not get a hello?
Come through. Freezing night. I better put the dog away from chocolate. Dogs can't eat chocolate.
Oh, can it not?
But I certainly can. Oh, so.
You'll ruin your appetite, Mark.
Thank you so much. I'll just put this in the kitchen and then I'll grab your coat.
Nice to meet you, Jane.
This is Marvin, by the way, darling.
Yes, they've met.
I think Jane took an instant dislike to Marvin as soon as she walked through the door.
It was a stupid dog. It kept coming up to me. Sniffing all the time. I don't want nobody sniffing me. Human or animal, no sniffing. Oh, my God, what's it doing?
It's welcoming the next guest. Too manly for a coat, Kev.
Hello.
Hello, come in. How are you doing, Kev? You all right?
Good,
coming out of that cold.
Hiya.
Hi, Kev. How are you?
Nice to see you again. Look lovely again.
Oh, do you do?
Have you met Marvin? Thank you.
Hiya, Marvin.
Little Marvin.
You're looking very minty tonight, Kev, eh?
Cool.
Fresh and minty.
Good.
Last to arrive is cable TV's Sally Jacks, wearing a jacket she couldn't possibly vlog on the telly.
Look who it
is. I love it!
Who's this?
That's more cute than you.
Oh my God.
No, it's
darling.
Gorgeous. Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Nice to see you. Lovely.
You too, how are you?
Yeah, very good.
Cheers, there we go, that's for you.
Thank you. Hello, Marvin. Come for cuddles.
Whilst Marvin deals with front of house, in the kitchen, Mark's frying his starter of baby deer. He garnishes his plates with salad leaves and French beetroot.
So the parsnip chips are nearly ready. It's looking good. I think serving a meat a lot of people are used to is always a worry. However, I'm sure that they're going to love this.
And if not, doggy bag for Marvin. Well, here it is, fillet of venison. But before actually serving it, he's got something even fancier up his sleeve.
Now, guys, if you flip the menu on the table over, there's a little selection of some wines for you to choose from.
Didn't have one of those on your night, did you, Jane?
What would you recommend, being a wine connoisseur?
I would probably go for the Crianza.
OK. Darling, the wine menu. It was ace. Turn your menu over, love. Look at that cracker. Brilliant.
I'll just say that I've never had venison before.
Mm-hmm.
My girlfriend once tried to order it off a specials board. She said, I think I'll go for the venison. I don't even know what it is. And I said, it's deer. She said, I don't care what it costs. I want to try it.
Good one, Kev.
I've never tried venison before, and it was absolutely fantastic.
I actually don't like venison. I'm sorry,
it's okay.
But I'm going to try it.
What don't you like about venison? Its taste?
Too strong.
It is a strong meat.
Yeah.
I didn't like her starter last night, so she was bound to pick on something of mine tonight. And she picked on my venison starter.
It's not something that I would choose on a menu, but I'm eating it.
The claws might be out tonight. It means I have to focus on two other guests to make sure I get the highest scores from them. So, guys, how do you actually feel about dogs at the dinner table? You've obviously got...
I've got no issues.
Dogs.
I love all dogs and all breeds.
Marvin, I don't class him as a dog, cos obviously we're a gay couple, we're probably not going to have kids, so actually we class him as our little baby.
Yeah, well, I class mine.
But he's not a baby, is he?
He is still a baby. He's a baby dog.
He's a baby dog.
Yeah. I class mine as my babies.
I don't think the issue is whether you're a baby or not.
But they're not.
But they are. They're my babies. How dare you say they're not my babies?
Babies come out from there with two legs, not four.
It's become apparent that Jane does not like dogs in any way, shape or form. I'm sure Jane would prefer it if I was a taxidermist and Marvin was stuffed.
Well, as long as he's still wearing the tank top, it's time for the second lamb main of the week.
The battle has made its way to my house tonight. Lamb yesterday, lamb tonight. Bland lamb on a bone or tasty lamb in a confit. Let's see who wins.
Let's! Mark's warmed through his sausagey thing, which he now plates up.
This looks absolutely fantastic.
Swords at the ready, on guard! It's lamb confit with mango salsa and red currant reduction.
It's battle of the lambs.
It is indeed. Let fight commence.
Mmm. Oh my God, that's not fat at all. I didn't feel the fattiness as what I did last night. So I thought it was better in that sense. Have you reduced the sauce yourself?
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
It's port, red wine, red currant jelly.
It was absolutely delicious. The only thing I didn't get was the mango.
Oh, here we go.
No. No mango with lamb. They're not even from the same island.
Sorry.
This food's absolutely fantastic, like Sally says, no fat in it whatsoever. And I really like this mango salsa. It's another first for me.
It's a week of firsts.
Yeah.
What's going to come up on the next night?
Me cooking. Jane's food was excellent. Mark's food's been excellent. The standard has been extremely high.
I really think this evening I've cooked a top-notch main course. And in my opinion, it's the best dish so far in this competition.
Well, don't peek too soon. There's still dessert to come.
Wow, that looks amazing.
Of course it does. He sprinkles on grated white chocolate before pouring the coulis into shot glasses.
Absolutely amazing. Pudding perfection. £1,000. Get it into my bank account.
Time to see if he's on the money with his white chocolate cheesecake served with raspberry vodka sauce.
My favourite dessert.
Is it? I hope you enjoy.
Oh, that's gosh, just... That looks delicious.
Oh, I think that's absolutely brilliant.
Mark, am I meant to be able to taste the vodka? Does it make it a bit more liquid?
If you have a bit of the coulis on its own, you get a hint of the vodka.
No.
I'll tell you what your problem might be. You might have had too many of them sherbets, love, because I can taste it.
Crikey! Scores, please!
I've had a fantastic evening tonight. Some brilliant food, topped off by some quality drink and the best cheesecake that I've ever tasted. And for that reason, I'm giving Mark a 9.
The highlight to me was the cheesecake, and what an atmosphere. And because of that, I'm going to score Mark an 8.
Mark has tried really hard, but I didn't like the venison. It was cold and overcooked. The main course, mango with lamb, I didn't get.
Oh, heck.
And the pudding was great, but there was no vodka in the Kool-Aid. And I give Mark a 6.
Jane's night's over. My night's over. Put the two together. No question, my night was better.
Sadly not. You scored 23. Exactly the same as rival Jane. Coming up, Disco Fever.
Disco Chicken, oh, come on.
And Murder on the Dance Floor.
Never managed to get the chicken how I wanted. Have you got it stuck?
It's day 3 in Burnley, where DJ Kev Riley is up early and raring to host his first ever dinner party. Hopefully breakfast isn't a taste of things to come.
I know I'm not an experienced cook, and I've made no secret of that. What I may lack on cooking ability, I'm going to make up for in hosting.
Kev says he's not a cook, so I don't really know what he's going to pull out the bag, really.
Jane and Mark have both been very sophisticated. I reckon Kev's got something else up his sleeve. I think he's going to go down a completely different route. And do you know what? I'd love that.
A completely different route indeed. Kev's main is disco chicken.
What the hell's that?
Disco chicken. Oh, come on. Brilliant. Is the chicken going to be dancing on my plate?
It will if he forgets to cook it.
My main is called Disco Chicken, just after me, a DJ. Disco Chicken.
Sounds logical.
Baking, cooking does not come naturally to me. I'm literally having to think very carefully before each step.
You seem to be doing very well. He creates a sauce by frying chopped chorizo with Parmesan cheese.
I don't really like the smell of this.
I'm sure it'll taste better. Kev then combines cream with his smelly cheese. This disco sauce will be warmed later when he pan-fries the chicken.
Get in there. Sorted.
Now he's on a roll, Kev has a go at his starter. Creamy Lancashire stuffed peppers.
That sounds gorgeous. What's in them, then?
We'll soon find out.
The secret ingredient of my starter is marjoram.
Get you!
I'd not heard of marjoram before last week.
Oh.
When I was asked to get it, I thought she said get more jam.
Been getting help.
I had to take advice when I was practicing on how to turn the oven on.
Yeah, you'd think he'd be used to twiddling knobs in his line of work.
That's that done.
By Jove, he's done it! The peppers will be cooked once his guests arrive.
I'm really looking forward to seeing the outcome.
For dessert, Kev's attempting Millie's malted milk cheesecake.
It's the battle of the cheesecakes in Burnley.
I do like cheesecake. Mmm, looks a great menu.
Another popular choice, Kev. To make the base, he melts butter.
I'm very nervous about doing this. It's looking like it's got chilli flakes in it, so I'm going to start again. Always wash your pans before you begin.
He's learning fast. Kev starts again, adding sugar and malted biscuits to the non-chilli flaked butter before moving on to the filling.
Can't quite remember how much I'm going to put the oil in.
It doesn't seem to matter. Kev's making two layers for his cheesecake, one with white chocolate, the other with milk chocolate. Very fancy.
See what that tastes like.
Verdict?
Perfect.
Smashing. Finally, he places one chocolate layer on top of the other and chills. The boy's done good.
Hey,
hello.
Mom.
How are you?
Come in, mate.
Cheers. Are you well?
Yeah.
Good.
You bought my fluid of love.
Good.
Glad you like. Thanks
very much. Okay, simmer down.
So you're looking forward to tonight?
I am looking forward to it now.
Yeah.
The preparation's out the way. And especially after following up two really, really good evenings. Oh. You know, I think Jane will be the toughest to impress.
Yeah, I struggled last night.
I think she's got high standards.
Oh, do you reckon? Next to arrive is cable TV fixture Sally, wearing something else she couldn't sell on the box.
Hey!
Hey! It's party time!
Where's the disco? I can't wait for disco chicken.
Can you not? Right.
Come on, bring it on.
Disco.
Let's disco. I bought my disco outfit for you.
Oh, that's what it is.
Oh, my. Oh, you darling, you OK?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, brilliant.
I thought this is going to be one wild night.
Last at the door is the guest to impress, Jane.
Hi, Kev. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Fabulous. I've made you a Merry Berry liqueur. I thought you quite might like it.
Does he look like a liqueur man?
Brilliant.
Hello. Hi,
how are you? All right, thank you.
Flat meeting Kylie.
No, it's definitely Sally.
Hey, I'll put this down here with my collection of...
What's that?
It's Merry Berry liqueur. I make it and it's all berries soaked in vodka.
Oh, my God.
So, I just thought it'd
that
be...
That sounds divine.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Best to palm it off, then.
Right, if you want to just chill out a minute, I'm just going to get you started ready.
Excellent.
Cheers.
Enjoy your drinks, guys.
Cheers.
With guests trying to figure out how Sally got into her outfit, Kev's about to plate up his starter.
I'm really impressed with how they've turned out. They're the best peppers that we've had this week.
Ha-ha! And here they are. Yeah.
Is there any of the ingredients in this that anybody doesn't like?
Yeah, the peppers.
Love it.
Do you know what, Kev? That cheese is really nice.
Oh, it's
good.
Yummy with the pepper. It tastes great.
I thought we having cheese in it might be a little bit heavy with the peppers, but it definitely was not. It was great.
They ate it all. I'm pulling it off so far. Come on.
With his starter a surprise hit, it's on to the next big challenge. Frying chicken.
The tricky bit of this is knowing what's a medium heat and what's a high heat. I can't really tell by looking at this blue stuff going on.
The blue stuff is gas, Kev.
I'm liking that the flames have shrunk.
I think you must have turned it down.
I've done this three times. I've never managed to get the chicken how I want it.
Here's hoping tonight's the night, then. Well, they look all right. Kev plates up his fillets with potatoes and beans, topped off with the chorizo sauce. It's disco time!
There you go.
That looks delicious.
You call it disco because you're DJing.
Yeah. First time I've cooked chicken all by myself.
Really?
Doctor!
Have you got it stuck?
No, I'm trying to speak, so I'm trying to swallow. That's the first time you've cooked chicken?
Mm.
Ever?
Today?
Yeah.
To say he's never cooked before, to land that on your plate, well, gee whiz. Absolutely fantastic.
Kev, this is gorgeous, thank you.
Thanks, Mark. That means a lot to me coming from you.
Mm, I'm well impressed.
Yeah?
It is absolutely delicious, actually.
I am a little surprised that they complimented it so much. Because they have a higher knowledge of food, maybe a bit more fussy might be the word.
Sod the pretentiousness and the thought and creating a wine list, Kev has got it right.
I would never ever put food on a coloured plate, and Kev used red plates.
Well, bad luck, because he's serving dessert on some too.
Presentation is key to this dish, and as you can see, I'm making the balls up of it.
Yes.
Half a Jane's is in Mark. Get off there. I'll fight better than that.
Well saved, Kev. Here it is, Millie's malted cheesecake with a side order of giant cutlery.
Big spoon.
That's a serving spoon, Kev.
Yeah, I know. The only ones that are clean.
Well, that's a good reason.
Would you like a little spoon? I'll get you a little spoon.
No, it's all right.
Is he just saying that you've got a big gob?
Steady.
Just tell me what you think of it. I'll be interested to know.
A spoon's big enough.
Oh, nearly took half of it with me.
You needed a big spoon to get down. I should have put a chisel on.
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
Mm, it is, actually.
Kev, I don't really like malt biscuits.
Oh. Really?
So don't be offended if I don't eat it all.
No.
So what didn't you like?
You could always add your top bigger.
There she goes. Yeah. Taxi!
Jane will pick holes in everything. You could create the perfect dish by Gordon Ramsay, Heston Blumenthal, and still she would pick holes.
Tonight, I've had a really good time. The only thing I didn't like was pudding. So tonight, I'm giving a 7.
Having never thrown a dinner party before, I have to give it my utmost respect. And for that, I'm going to give Kev a 7.
I'm going to give Kev an 8.
Oh, so close! Kev's first ever dinner party scores a very respectable 22 points.
I'm really proud of myself tonight, and now they've gone, I can give myself a pat on the back.
Good for you, Kev! In the spotlight today, where she's very, very happy, is TV's Sally Jacks, who's holding the final dinner party of the week.
The real challenge for me is obviously making everybody love it. Mark's an exceptional cook. I want him to like it. Kev, you know, he can put on amazing parties. I want him to like it. And Jane, very competitive as well. I don't want her to find anything wrong.
Sally's given nothing away all week. I think we have a little dark horse creeping through this competition. She might wow us all tonight with the best dinner party.
She might. For her dessert, she's serving gelato cake with chocolate sauce and strawberries.
I am a cake lover. You can see by the size of me. And chocolate and strawberries, yum, yum.
There's not a lot to it, really, is there?
She started early. In the kitchen, Sally's shaving some chocolate.
No chocolate for doggies. My main concern is that it's not going to be set properly tonight.
Come on, girl, let's give it the big sell. In Sally's kitchen today, she's preparing gelato cake, miniature dogs not included, using the very latest in whisking technology. I'm so sorry.
Thick but soft, Sally. Like me.
Cream whipped. She adds the shaved chocolate, orange liqueur and crushed meringues.
Jane probably would have made her own meringues. I haven't got time.
She pops the mixture into tubes and leaves to set. Now onto the starter. Stuffed peppers again.
Not a complex dish.
What's she going to stuff it with?
Obviously, that's going to be similar to mine. Or maybe not. Maybe she won't be able to pull it off.
Some kind of chef now, are we?
Kev's stuffed peppers were beautiful. You're always going to say your own are better, aren't you? Hey? Oh.
Sally's also planning to outdo Kev on the joke front.
What does she say when it looks in the mirror? Halloumi!
Oh, right, because of halloumi cheese. Yeah, good one.
This is halloumi cheese. That is cracking.
Yeah, don't give up the daytime TV job.
Sally slices up the cheese and combines with fried mushrooms, spring onion and couscous.
Oh, my God, that's amazing.
Then she stuffs her peppers. Last up, main course, fish and chips.
Where's she going to the chippery?
The chippery?
Fish and chips, come on.
I expected Sally to have more upper-class hoity-toity food.
This is a posh fish and chips, darling.
This may be a winning menu for me, but I'm not sure it will be for the competition.
Food critic as well now, eh?
Don't like the smell of fish.
Is it off?
I was going to batter it, but last time I did it, I set fire to the kitchen, so I didn't think it was very good.
Fair enough. Sally will pan-fry her fillets tonight.
Right, the biggest job of the night now is going to get the old wall paint on.
You've only got 3 hours. Whilst Sally's gearing up for battle, Jane's gearing up to break the door down. I think she knows someone's at the door.
Hello, lovely!
Oh,
I like a good set of knockers.
Most people prefer a doorbell.
How are you?
Oh. That was crazy. Come in, come
you
out,
look nice.
It's only you. Come in.
This is a little gift for you of me.
Can we put this in the shampoos?
Yes, I thought you might like to do that. That's why I brought it.
Oh, my gosh, would you like some of that?
No, thank you, cos I don't like it.
Still trying to get rid of that liqueur, Jane. Wonder if Kev's got a better present.
Hello.
Oh, my word!
What is that?
Jay, where have you got that from? Oh, that's so good. Where have you got that from?
The skip.
You really want to know?
Oh, that is brilliant. Hang on, let me take you to the lounge. Come on in, boy. What would you like? Would you want a lager or do you want champagne?
Champagne, yeah.
Ooh, la-di-da!
You want champagne and lager?
Well, yeah, it's over the evening.
Save some for final guest, Mark, who's turned up with half a tropical rainforest.
Very delicate knot.
That's for a delicate person, darling.
Oh, my God, that's so good!
My, you're excitable tonight.
Oh, that's ice.
I have come as a tribute to Sally Jack.
Oh,
that
is so
what, by wearing a hoodie?
Good.
Really?
Oh, Mark's tribute. Amazing, amazing. Absolutely fantastic.
Fantastic!
How good is that?
Absolutely. Come as a tribute to the great Sally Jack.
Oh,
well,
my God.
I think you look fabulous.
I can't, honestly, that's just made me cry. I had tears in my eyes. It was so good.
Coming up, revelations.
There was definitely tactics involved. Sneaky.
Recriminations.
Each night, you've actually pointed out areas where we've all sort of failed.
And results are revealed.
Fourth place.
It's the last night in Burnley, and glamorous TV presenter Sally Jacks is hosting the final dinner party of a ferociously tight competition.
I feel physically sick. Raring to go!
She's kicking off her night with the second stuffed pepper dish of the week.
They've got more filling in than Kev's. That's the difference between mine. Obviously, I'm going to say mine are better because anybody would.
And here they are.
Jane.
There we go. Wow. That looks delicious. That's your...
Thanks, darling. What?
Starter looked amazing. When it came out, I thought, whoa, I've got some competition here.
Did you nick your presentation off My Peppers last night?
I did see you taking photos.
I did.
Oh, Sally, that's delicious.
Do you like that?
Yummy.
Please.
The stuffed peppers were really nice. Sally is a good cook. I think she was blagging us all week.
No, she just wasn't bragging.
Sweet. This is...
You really like
really,
it?
Really, really good, yeah.
Delicious.
I was so worried about Jane and Mark's response that...
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Oh, well chuffed. Really chuffed.
You don't need to sing for your supper if you've cooked it. But Sal's an old pro, don't you know?
I used to do turn with Box Fizz. I used to sing with Box Fizz.
No. What?
No!
And you're only telling us now?
No, it was with Mike Nolan, who was from the original, and David Van Day. So I sang with them. I did that for 4 years. I toured all around with them for 4 years.
Wow.
It was such good fun. Such good fun.
Never ending story. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's what they sang.
No, that was Limahl.
We used to do Making Your Mind Up.
Rip your skirt off.
No. Just taking our tops off.
Your bras?
No. Oh. Tops.
Didn't have a bra on?
I did, but one fell out. One wanted to peek at audience.
Well, he's hoping your main course isn't a hooter, Sally.
Stay open. Down, boy.
It won't talk back. She pan fries her fish fillets, adds sweet potato chips, homemade sauces and mushy peas. And it's ready.
There we go.
Oh, that looks delicious.
Wow.
There we go.
It's not what I expected, but it's absolutely fantastic.
Oh, thank
Tastes
you.
Tastes brilliant.
Thank you very much, Kev. Thank you.
Jane?
Very surprised how Sally's pulled off her menu, because I expected fish and chips, and it was a posh fish and chips.
It was more impressive what she did, but for me, I would have preferred the old fish and chip supper.
Well, you can always pop to the chippery on your way home.
How's that fish for you, Mark?
Absolutely divine.
Really?
Mm. I've had posh fish and chips in a few restaurants, but that fish is just cut perfectly.
Sally tonight, with what she's created in tonight's meal, has got some real talent there. All week, she has really played that down.
The only thing I don't like is the peas.
Oh, yeah?
Okay. And I do like peas with my fish, but I'm not very keen on them peas, but don't be offended.
Do you know why? Do you not like creme fraiche and mint?
Yeah, I do.
So what didn't you like, Jane?
I didn't like the mushy peas, and I thought the chips were a bit wet.
Did you double cook your chips?
No, I did them in the oven.
All right, yeah.
I did them in the oven.
She didn't double bake, and I did comment on that.
A little bit disappointed. She didn't like two of the things, but of course, you know, I can't have everything, and it is a competition at the end of the day.
Speaking of which...
Who's the most competitive between all us?
I think Jane.
Yeah, I think Jane.
I knew you were going to say that.
I agree.
Oh, you bunch of tossers.
Jane's face was a picture of shock, horror.
I don't think I've ever met anybody as competitive as you.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't enter a competition just for the fun of it. I enter it to try and win it.
After Jane, I'd say that next was Mark, if I had to say second.
Yeah, I think Mark's competitive.
Yeah, I would say as well.
I know that I'm competitive. I did think you were really competitive in the fact that each night you've actually pointed out areas where we've all sort of failed.
Oh,
whereas
really?
Other people have been a bit more gentle and soft about it. Actually, tonight, really enjoyed your company.
Oh, and have you not any other night?
No.
Oh, really? Have you not?
He's only joking, Jane. Well, that's a relief. On with the final course of the competition.
If that was served up in a restaurant, I'd be mighty fine. I think that's really good. So I'm hoping they think the same.
Sally serves her gelato cake with artfully placed strawberries and a soupçon of chocolate sauce. How refined.
Oh, that's wow. Thank you. That looks yummy. That.
Looks fabulous.
So have you got meringue in it?
Don't overdo it.
Does that taste good?
Yeah, good.
Dark horse, dark girl.
That was fabulous.
Whatever I put my mind to,
yeah,
I really, really try hard.
There was definitely tactics involved.
Yeah.
Definitely. Sneaky.
What do you mean? What does
well,
that mean?
Making out you're doing picking chips and then bringing that through.
I've pulled out everything I could possibly do. I'm just hoping and praying it falls my way tonight.
Jane and Mark are in first place with a score of 23, so they're the ones to beat.
It's been a fantastic evening tonight with some great people and some great food, and for that reason, I'm giving Sally 8.
I've had a great evening tonight. The food has been simple yet sophisticated. For that reason, I'm giving Sally an 8.
Another 8 will mean Sally trumps Jane and Mark.
I'm giving Sally a...
Hold on! The scoring's all in secret, and tonight's host will announce the results.
Right, guys? Oh, my gosh, I've never, ever seen this before.
It's your Bucks Fizz royalties, Sally.
Yay! Fourth place. Yay!
Oh, Kev.
I'm never. Cooler.
Are you sure?
Kev.
Cheers, Kev.
Yeah, no worries.
Can I give you a kiss?
No, carry on.
Can I?
No, definitely not. Carry on.
In your own time.
That's well weird.
We haven't got all night.
First place, Sally, Mark and Jane! Woo!
Jane scored Sally a 7, meaning Sally shares the win with Mark and Jane. Anyone going to get up?
I don't mind coming last. The key for me was to have a great time, which I've done.
Oh, you're only 1 point behind Kev.
I said that I was going to win at the beginning of this week. I have done. Well chuffed.
I can't believe it.
Well done, you three.
Well done.
Cheers.
Cheers. I am so unbelievably delighted that I've come in the same league as Jane and Mark. Shabba.